Hey guys, this is Romita Mundela and I am sailing as an ETO on board the vessel and I am sailing as an ETO on board container vessel since 2017. Coming to the questions which is being asked to me very commonly, like first question is why I have chosen this field as my career option. So my answer is very simple, because I have done electrical engineering, so I was looking for a profession which gives me more opportunity to explore in electrical technology, subject as control system and automation system, electrical and electronic system and repair, and refrigeration, high voltage equipment. So I was looking for the option which can give me opportunity to explore more in this subjects and in electrical technology. That is why I have chosen this field as an career. Second most important question is why I have chosen ETO, why not engine side or a tech side? So this is very tricky question, but I will answer it as simple as I can. There are many female seafarers in engine side as well as deck side, but if you see the proportion and ratio of female ETO on any vessel or company, for example, in my company, I am the first and the only lady ETO on board serving as an ETO. So this job is very unique and very rare. So that is why I am here as an ETO. I choose this field as my career option. So the last thing which I will share, people is asking me before entering this field, what advice I should give to newcomers in this field. So advice is very simple, like you should be very strong mentally as well as physically. You should be very strong in your knowledge, in your basic concepts. You should be capable of working in both engine side as well as deck side, as well as reefers if you are sailing in container vessels. So this is in short, I will say it's not a white collar job. You have to work very hard, both physically, mentally. Your decision making should be very perfect, because if I talk about ETO specifically, you should be very good in decision making, because you should be very good in your decision making, because you will be a lone guy on board who will decide what will work out for this situation, what will not. So you will be all alone on yourself. So you should be very strong mentally, physically, and your decision should be very strong enough. And the last question which is being asked to me is why or what makes me happy to be on board. So during entire day of lot of hard work and hectic day, but when you are struggling with some problem and you are trying to find out solution for the same, and you got the solution and you are successful in that problem to troubleshoot and find out the results, and you are getting an outcome for it. So that is the thing where you feel more happy professionally. And personally, after going back to my cabin, after doing all my watches, port duties and all the day after finishing, when I see a sunset in middle of the ocean, that makes me more happy, and that no other profession can give me. So I love to be at sea, and that's why I am here. That's all. Thank you.